Before we start making our loading system, we'll first want to have a way to clear our graph. This will be useful for us when loading, as otherwise if we didn't clear the graph view will simply hold elements that don't belong to the loaded graph. This can also be useful if you just want to start over, without needing to close and open up the window again. Thankfully, clearing the graph is quite a simple thing to do. To do it, let's add to our dsGraphView script. In here, in our utility methods region, we'll create a new method that will allow us to clear the graph. So under all the other methods, type in public void clear graph. Do note that a clear method already exists in the GraphView class, hence why I've named it clear graph instead. Inside, we'll simply iterate through every graph element and remove them. We have two ways of doing that. The first one is by iterating to the GraphView graph elements variable using its forEach method that the uQueryState structure provides, and then remove the element using the removeElement method. The second one is to use the deleteElements method and pass in the graphElements variable. However, because this variable is of type uQueryState, we will have to convert it to a list first, using the toList method. It's fine to use whichever one you prefer, but I'll go with the first one as we don't need to convert it to a list, so it's likely to be slightly more performant, but not so much that it matters in our case. The deleteElements method ends up scaling removeElement for each of the elements as well. So type in graphElements dot forEach, and I'll name the callback element graphElement, and set the callback to be removeElement, and pass in graphElement. Do note that we are using removeElement instead of remove, as the latter is for visualElements and not graphElements. With our graphElements being removed, we'll now simply clear our dictionaries and our property to make sure the next graph works without any problem. So type in groups.clear, groupedNodes.clear, and then groupNodes.clear. For our property, simply set it to 0, so nameErrorsAmount equals to 0. If you aren't using the serializable dictionary from IPSpin link and are using another one instead, I had to add keyPositions.clear to its clear method for it to work, as otherwise an error will be thrown. If you are using IPSpin link serializable dictionary, then it's already there and you don't need to worry about it. With that done, we'll now create a toolbar button so that we can clear our graph whenever we want. So in our DS editor window, go to our addToolbar method and create a new button, which I'll name clearButton, and assign dsElementUtility.createButton with clear as a text and an empty callback that calls a new method named clear. I'll add this method to the toolbar actions region. In here, we'll simply need to call our GraphViewClear method by typing in graphView.clearGraph. This next one is not really necessary, but also add a button that both clears the graph elements and resets the graph filename to a default name. So in our addToolbar method, copy the clear button and paste it in again. Then, swap the clear with reset instead. For our method call, we'll need to call it resetGraph as the editor window already has a reset method. I'll place this method under our clear method. We'll need a way to reset our name, and because I know we'll need it when we make our loading system, I'll create a new method in our utility methods above all the other methods that updates the filename. So type in public static void update filename and pass in string new filename as a parameter. We are making it public because we'll need it when loading the graph. We can update our filename using the filename textfill variable. However, because this method is static, the variable needs to be static as well for us to use it here. So above in our variables, be sure to make it static. Then, back to our method, type in filename textfield.value equals to new filename. In our resetGraph method, we'll start by clearing our graph by calling the clear method, and then update our filename by typing in update filename and passing in default filename. Of course, we should add our buttons to the toolbar for them to show. So in our addToolbar method, type in toolbar.add and pass in clear button. And toolbar.add and pass in reset button. Saving and going back to Unity, we shall now be able to clear and reset our graph.